Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers. This episode taking a look at the 2x2 wheels of vanilla with a compact suspension by Spaz86. As well as the panneau solar panels by the Maxime 7080. And then the shower lights by Chipsticks 1213. Although actually getting the showers down with the lights is a bit weird, but simple. Anyway, let's take a look at shower lights first. We've got one over here, and it's quite quick to go through. So first person, see here, you see a little glow there showing that the lights are on. And if I was to go over here, type in shower, because it's doing down, so I renamed this one to display. And see, it's fully configurable lights. So you can make them red, or green, or any other color you want. Now placing it down is a bit different than you'd expect. Because we have this G menu here, as the toilets, as well as the shower itself. The only problem doing it for this way is that it doesn't have the lights. So going through that menu gives you the original vanilla versions. If you search for it in the G menu and put down your hotbar, place it down, now you got your lights. And other than that, they just function the same as any other light. Thus, you no longer have to have dark toilets or showers. Thus, they can now be lit up, which is handy. Thus, if you have one like this, it'll all be lit up and you can see what you're doing. It's pretty good. Kind of weird how the sound of the wind just disappeared there. Huh. Anyway, as for the build cost, it's don't believe it's any different from vanilla. 20 interior plates, 20 construction components, 12 small steel tubes, and 8 bulletproof glass. Yeah, it's the exact same as vanilla. So we could... That's not a vanilla one. Nee. Now we can check them. And... Yeah, it is the same as vanilla. As you can see. So you do need the decorative blocks to DLC in order to use it. So it's best not to add the mod unless you have that. Neat. Now, how about we take a look at the wheels? Since they are the same as the wheels we've done before, in pretty much every way except from the wheel it uses. Both small and large ships. You've got your 3x3 here, your 2x2, and your 1x1. With the full block suspension and the flat suspension. Thus allowing you to have more compact wheels on your vehicles, but now with the original vanilla wheels. So you don't need DLC for it anymore. So I believe the ones I'm using over here require the DLC in order to get these. I think it's annoying. That's the original. It doesn't mention anything about needing the mod or DLC. And back over I go. Bouncy. So you got your 1x1, 2x2s, 3x3s, and vanilla style. Thus you now have options for what you want. I wonder if someone should come out with even more style wheels for this. Ah, could work. I think one thing that would be pretty cool as well, which I'm not sure would be possible to program in, is that when you go to the add wheel, there's actually multiple options that let you choose which style of wheel you want. Thus you can easily just pop up a wheel and replace it with a new style. That may not be possible, but who knows. Be fun. Although these block ones have the same issue as the others. There can't be a block underneath them when you place it down. Otherwise the wheel won't be there. Which is a big pain in the ass, but oh well, never mind. Maybe because the wheels will be clipping into the block, like they're doing now. So anyway, why don't we move on to the solar panels? Just three very simple ones. First, we have a square with the indicators on both sides. We have a triangle with the indicator on both sides. And then we have the ramp, indicating the top button. And not only that, they're on the other sides. Because these are fully, well, they're double-sided, so it doesn't matter which side you have up, they will still work. This allowing you to have even more configurations. Considering the block that these are on is this part here. Thus you can either have it laying down flat on your grid, or you can use it as part of a roof. If you're even airtight. Are they airtight? Airtight, not sealed. Oh, that's a shame. So these will enable you to pretty much they fill any blank space on your ship with a solar panel. Or even create entire shells out of solar panels. It's allowing you to generate power at any point. If I haven't even checked how much these produce. Oops. We'll do that. Let's plop down a vanilla so we have something to compare it to. And here is vanilla. Now we have one over here. Hoping they come up. It's a Spanish mod, I think. Is it? Oh dear. So, for vanilla, the maximum possible output is 160 kilowatts. These be going down. As for these, the maximum output is 100 megawatts. Well, for the ramped one anyway. The triangle is also 100, and the square is 100. So, each individual panel is weaker than vanilla, but considering you can place 8 of those down in the place of one of those, so you'll be able to get a maximum of 800 kilowatts instead of just 160. So you're better off with these than you are vanilla. You would just end up with a ton of squares. In fact, what's the build cost of these? It's a total of 15 steel plates, 35 construction components, 20 girders, 15 computers, 16 solar cells, and 20 bulletproof glass. As for you, you're the same. Yeah, same. And same. And you? Okay. It's only 4 steel plates, 14 construction components, 12 girders, 4 computers. Why am I saying this is vanilla? Either way, these are more expensive in general items, but cheaper in solar cells. I guess because they're thicker. So look how thick they are. Quite thick compared to this. Anyway, not by much. The frick? Why are these so significantly more expensive than these ones? Huh. So yeah, although you will be saving... The amount of cells you get out of one of these will take up... will only be enough for two of these. You're still getting more power out of it in general. But they are a lot more expensive everywhere else. Huh. Expensive little buggers. But at least, in surface area, they will produce significantly more. Also be a great deal more significantly expensive. Oh well, never mind. Still be useful. Now I was also going to be doing the spider infestation mod, but they only spawn on the cargo ships that randomly spawn in space. And unfortunately, I have those disabled for this world. You know, to they don't use up server, well, processing capabilities or capacity. Yeah, so we can have everything focused on the mods. And the base. Big base. Big base, that is quite large on the inside. Yeah, still a work in progress. Still got a lot to do to finish it off. Anyway, I will have links for all three mods in the description below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.